The authority was quizzed on why there is no tangible evidence for the monies it has been receiving from the government.
2006, when this authority was established, there is nothing tangible to show. Actually, when you go to a place like Bunyoro, where I come from, specifically Hoima, this is news. Nobody has ever heard about it. It means this thing is in limbo.
According to the documents presented to the committee by the authority's managing director, a total of 274 storage facilities were physically inspected by the authority, while 268 commodity handlers from 57 warehouses were trained in weighing, grading, and sampling of commodities. However, the 2022 Auditor General's report indicates that the authority never inspected any single warehouse in the country. The sample report indicates that out of the approved budget of 3 billion Ugandan shillings, the authority had 2 billion shillings, which was released to its coffers through the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives.
The warehouse is put in place to regulate that we get that good quality, we hold it somewhere, and it cannot be done without them liaising with other agencies.
There is no value for money, and I believe we should have done more as an authority.
The Uganda Warehouse Receipt Systems Authority is mandated to license storage facilities, storage keepers and handlers at the warehouse, storage inspectors, and to issue negotiable warehouse receipts. The committee chairperson, Mwine Mpaka, revealed that the actions by the authority are causing financial loss to the government.
We had come to discover was the challenges faced by warehouses, but we have now also realized that we have an authority that is operating under no legal framework and spending government resources, therefore causing financial loss.
Some committee members recommended that the authority be disbanded.
The receipt system authority should be disbanded and merged with, for example, UNBS. We want us to